Welcome back to my channel. How are you guys? I hope you're good. In today's video I want to talk about periods. And why? Because it's not that common topic to talk about, you know, when you think about a woman in a wheelchair. Have you ever thought what or how that how women in wheelchair deal with periods? And if they have periods? Of course they have. It's just something normal, it's just something that happens to the body and we cannot change it no matter what. You know, we had a spinal cord injuries, we cannot walk anymore and stuff like that, but that doesn't stop our body of functioning normal. And that's a part of the body, of the function of the body. Periods are not funny at all. But we have to deal with it. And what do? We have so many solutions on the market to deal with periods. And there are some of them, like the period panties. They're so famous everywhere. You can buy the panties. I will tell my experience about period panties. Pads, that we know them. The tampon, that we know it. The cup period, and yeah, there is also the solution of not having the period by taking the pill, but that's another topic. So coming back to the solution that I just said, this is just told, the period panties. My personal experience with period panties is not fun at all, because either the material of the panties was just fake, like not doing what it is supposed to do, or I have too much period, but I don't think so. So it says that you take the period panties and then for 4 or 5 hours you shouldn't have no problem. I did try that, but it went wrong. And probably I would have checked also more, but I trusted the period panties, but it did went wrong. So if you have good experience with period panties, please share it with me in the comments below. Share where did you order the panties, because I'm curious. Perhaps I did order from the wrong side or so. The same goes for pads, and I would say that the period panties and the pads, so both of these are not actually a really good solution for me, only if I have to stay home, because then it comes the problem when I have to catheterize myself. I need to be able to either go on a toilet or you know, transfer in the bed. It would be really, really difficult if I'm outside, or perhaps impossible on my own, or I need to ask help of someone. But that's not nice, as you can imagine. I did try the pads, I did try the period panties, that are not the best solution for me. The best solution for me is the tampon. You know, I just need to check up from time to time, change it as it's supposed to, and all the things. But other things is just normal. What I have tried is also the pill for not having the period, which is, you know, the ideal solution. But you know, I don't recommend it. First of all, go and see a specialist and ask if it's possible with you know, your kind of situation, because we are different. And with the medication that you're taking, if it's possible for you. And taking the pill, it, you know, counts also for the future, if you want kids or not, because they say that it might influence, if you take the pill for too long, it might influence of getting pregnant and all the things. But that's another topic. We also want to talk about the symptoms before and during the period. In my personal experience is that I do get signals before my period would come. I would need to pee more often than normal and for smaller quantities. So that's already for me a sign like, oh, I need to watch out. And other than that, my pain is higher 1 week before the period. It's getting higher. I get to sleep really bad, even if I would take something for the pain, but I don't. Probably wouldn't help. I did try to take as a recommendation from a doctor to take before and during the period ibuprofen. That's probably a common medication, ibuprofen, worldwide. And it was recommended, so I took it for 3 months or so, but I saw no result in pain before and during my period, so I stopped it. It had no sense to take it. But other than that, other kind of pain medication I don't take and I don't want to. Anyway, and I was saying about the pain, so I do get to sleep really bad, like, you know, can't sleep at all sometimes. I just would stay awake the entire night without any reason why, or my pain being higher on my lower back or in my legs being restless. As I said, periods are not funny, but we need to look for solution. And you know, I would say that I'm lucky. My advantage is that I feel my body under my injury. If you want to see the sensitivity test that I did, I have a video on my channel about that. I also don't need to worry about not feeling during the period. Perhaps it's a advantage, disadvantage that I do feel, because then I do feel pain more during that period. The difference between someone that is able-bodied, a woman that's able-bodied, and a woman in wheelchair is that we need to check more often, perhaps to change and etc., because not everyone feels below their injury, so they need to check more and all the things. But I would say an advantage is that if it's messed up, you know, you can easily hide it. So anyway, that was what I wanted to share with you guys about the period and being in a wheelchair. It's just something that happens and we have to deal with, and it doesn't make any that big difference with someone that is able-bodied. Thank you for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and see you in the next video. Bye.